الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أنه محمدا عبده ورسوله ما بعد إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Inshallah, from tonight we will do two halqa, two subjects, inshallah. Each subject, inshallah, 40 minutes, bidhnillah, about 40 minutes. So we'll continue the halqa, the book, as we mentioned last week, the book of akhlaq, the ahadith related to the akhlaq. And the new subject, it will be about the aqeedah, inshallah. Inshallah, I will talk about the aqeedah from a book written by one of the shaykh in Saudi. He is a student of Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen. His name is Khalid Limshaygih. He wrote a small book in aqeedah. And this is nice to know all the subjects in aqeedah, all the titles in aqeedah. Because as we mentioned in the Thursday halqa, the importance of aqeedah. طيب, he started the book with the definition. What is the meaning of al-aqeedah? When the scholars say the term al-aqeedah, what is the meaning of al-aqeedah? Al-aqeedah, it means al-i'tiqad wal-iman al-jazim, the strong belief. Al-aqeedah from the word, I mean, as a linguistic meaning, from al-uqda. What is the meaning of al-uqda? If you make a knot, and this, if you have a rope or a thread, then you make a rod, you tie it, it will be stronger or weaker? It will be stronger. Imagine if I tie this cable, then there is a knot. Okay, or a knot. Knot or nod?
No.
D, huh? Nod. So it will be stronger. So this is the meaning of al-aqeedah. You tie something inside your heart, so it is strong. This is the meaning of aqeedah. They say, al-iman al-jazm, the strong belief. But strong belief in what? In Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because here we are talking about al-aqeedah al-islamiyya, the Islamic creed. وَبِمَا يَجِبُ لَهُ مِنَ التَّوْحِيدِ, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the strong belief in Allah and the angels, the books, the messengers, the last day, and al-qadr, the destiny, the six pillars of iman. When we talk about the aqeedah in Islam, we are talking about the six pillars of iman. طيب, also, what is related to al-aqeedah, or another term of aqeedah, which is al-tawheed. Yeah, and the scholars, sometimes they, when they write about the aqeedah, they give a name, the title of the book, aqeedah, or they mention as-sunnah, or they mention al-tawheed, or they mention al-iman. Okay, all these terms, okay, refer to al-aqeedah. Okay, for example, kitab al-tawheed, what we are explaining every Thursday in the Masjid al-Uthman, written by Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahab. Also, there is another book called Al-Tawheed, written by Ibn Khuzaymah. Ibn Khuzaymah, one of the scholars in the 4th century or the 3rd century, Ibn Khuzaymah. طيب, Al-Iman, there is a book, Al-Iman, from Sheikh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. طيب, Al-Sunnah, Al-Khalal, Abu Bakr al-Khalal. طيب, so these different names for something, one thing. طيب, so when we say at-tawheed, what does it mean at-tawheed? From the word wahid, one. So Allah is one in his names, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is one in his attributes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. One in his actions, subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one can do the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like giving the life, like curing the people, or the animals, or anything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah has his own actions, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is huwa wahid, في أولوهيته. He is the one to be worshipped. سبحانه وتعالى. None deserve to be worshipped except Allah. This is the meaning of لا إله إلا الله. And this عقيدة or this توحيد, okay, not the same level. Maybe for one person is very strong and perfect, like the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام. Their عقيدة, their توحيد is perfect. And also, if you remember what we mentioned, I think you joined us first حلقة, Masjid al-Uthman. Okay, we mentioned the perfect people in their توحيد or in their عقيدة, they will enter the paradise when or how? Alaykum salam. How those people with perfect عقيدة, with perfect توحيد, how will they, alaykum salam, how they will enter the paradise? Do you remember the hadith we mentioned? They enter the paradise من غير حساب ولا عذاب, without punishment and without reckoning. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned the hadith in Bukhari. Okay, 70,000 enter the paradise بغير حساب ولا عذاب. If you remember, we said about them, they are the perfect people in their عقيدة. طيب, so the عقيدة in the hearts of people, in their life, in their actions, not the same level, different levels. Some people, their aqeedah is very strong, their tawheed is very strong and perfect. Some of them medium, some of them weak, subhanAllah. So the aqeedah has different level with the people. طيب. And about the aqeedah, there is a minimum aqeedah, which is acceptable. طيب. And there is something the perfect aqeedah. So if you remember the same hadith again, some people their aqeedah is very strong and perfect. They don't ask people the ruqya. If you remember, we said those people who will enter the paradise without punishment, without reckoning. Okay, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned four things. صح. هم الذين لا يسترقون ولا يكتوون ولا يتطيرون وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. Okay. So one of them, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وَلَا يَسْتَرْقُونَ. What is the meaning of يَسْتَرْقُونَ? Many scholars said, يَسْتَرْقُونَ, it means they don't ask others the ruqya. What is the meaning of ruqya? Do you know what is the meaning of ruqya?
Incantation. Spells.
Spells what? Yes, to recite the Quran or the Hadith on someone who is sick, on yourself or on others. This is called ruqya. I have pain here in my hand, then I recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Or my son has a fever, then I put my hand and I recite Ayatul Kursi. Allahu la ilaha illa huwa. Why? Because I want Allah to cure him. So this is called ruqya. Okay, so asking ruqya, the Prophet said, لا يسترقون. Many scholars said, لا يسترقون means they don't ask the others to make ruqya for themselves. So if you ask the ruqya, so you'll not be among the 70,000 people. Okay, is it haram to ask people the ruqya? It is not haram. It is allowed, but your tawheed will be less. But it is not less the minimum. This is called Tawheed al-Wajib. I'm not doing shirk, but I'm asking people the ruqya. Okay? So your Tawheed is not perfect. Okay? So this is called Tawheed al-Wajib, the minimum with a compulsory Tawheed. But if you are not asking the people the ruqya, then your Tawheed will be perfect and strong. Okay? Then he discussed the what are the principles of aqeedah? The principles of aqeedah, the foundations of aqeedah, the six pillars, the pillars of aqeedah, the six points which are mentioned in the hadith. أن تؤمن بالله, to believe in Allah, ملائكته, كتبه, ورسله, واليوم الآخر, بالقدر, خيره وشره. These are the foundations of aqeedah. طيب, the six points, the main six pillars the six pillars of Aqidah. طيب. Then he mentioned, inshallah later we'll mention them in details. Then he mentioned, what are the sources to study the Aqidah? This is also very important. I should know from where I take my Aqidah. I take my Aqidah from math books, from science books, from engineer, medical books. I take my Aqidah from where? From the Quran and from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the consensus of the scholar, the Salaf, mainly the companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. When we talk about the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it should be the authentic Sunnah. And this is very important, the authentic Sunnah, the authentic hadith. You as Muslim, you have to take care about the authentic hadith only. We should don't use the weak hadith, the odd hadith, not authentic hadith. As Muslims, we have to follow the authentic hadith. Do we have authentic hadith or not? Yes, we have authentic hadith. The scholars told us what is the authentic hadith and what is the not authentic hadith. So if someone tells you, be careful, don't listen to the hadith, take only the Quran, because all the Quran authentic, and the hadith, we have doubt about the hadith. Many times you see the scholars saying this hadith is authentic, this hadith not authentic, and they are fighting about this hadith. So to be comfortable, ignore all the hadith and take only the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some people say this, and they are called Al-Qur'aniyun. Al-Qur'aniyun. They take their religion only from the Quran. They want to take the religion only from the Quran. And they want to ignore the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They ignore the hadith. Okay, and no doubt this is haram and this is kufr. This is kufr. He is not Muslim. Because in the Quran, Allah says, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Whatever comes from the Prophet ﷺ, from the Messenger, take it. And you say, we don't take the Sunnah. So it means you don't believe in the Quran. Allah told us to follow the Prophet ﷺ. Okay, if you don't have the Sunnah, how you can follow the Prophet ﷺ? So this is kufr. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. We have to follow the Quran and Sunnah. Which Sunnah? The authentic Sunnah. عَلَيْكَ السَّلَامُ كَيْفَ الْحَالِ لَا السَّلَامَ. The authentic Sunnah. So this is very important. And subhanAllah, because of the ignorance, people don't know how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected the Sunnah, preserved the Sunnah for us. Wallahi, if you read, يعني, even the kuffar, they know that the Muslims, only the Muslims who have this advantage, which is the knowledge of hadith. Something amazing. If you study the knowledge of hadith, wallahi ajeeb, something amazing. How our scholars protect the hadith for us. يعني subhanAllah, you'll be surprised how our scholars are very accurate about the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did he say حدثنا or he said أخبرنا? Did he put wa or it is without wa? Very accurate about the hadith. طيب subhanAllah, one of them said, they caught him, one deviant man who fabricated a lot of hadith. Then the emir wants to punish him. So this man, this deviant man said, okay, you want to punish me? And what you will do with the thousands or a lot of hadith that I fabricated, I created a lot of hadith, not authentic hadith. Even if you kill me, but you cannot stop the hadith. This Amir said, the leader of that place, he said, I don't care because, alhamdulillah, we have great scholars like this scholar. He mentioned some names like Yahya ibn Na'in, Imam Ahmed, Shu'b ibn Hajjaj. They can filter the hadith. It is easy for them. Or they can't do this. Don't worry, alhamdulillah, Allah protected the hadith through these scholars. يعني some عجيب stories, amazing story, البخاري. And you know البخاري. He is one of the greatest scholars of hadith. And the scholars of hadith, all of them, almost all of them, they traveled from one place to another place, seeking for the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So he went to a place because there is a scholar of hadith. So al-Bukhari wants to take the hadith from him. He wants to hear the hadith from him. So he went to that man and he saw the man feeding his donkey. He has a donkey or a horse. And he has a container of food, big one. He is calling his animal, his donkey or his horse. So al-Bukhari saw, noticed that there is nothing inside the container. So al-Bukhari said, "Khalas, I'm not take the hadith from him. I don't trust him. Why? Because he's lying with the animal. He's cheating the animal. He's showing the animal that I'm introducing food for you and there is no food inside. So I will not accept the hadith from him. I will not accept the hadith from him." SubhanAllah, so they are very careful. Some of the scholars, they will not write any hadith without doing wudu, without doing ablution. Every time they will do ablution. SubhanAllah. So they are very serious about the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So please, brothers, sisters, don't care about, don't listen to anyone who tries to accuse the books of hadith or the scholars of hadith. For sure, he is ignorant or he is a deviant person. He is a shaitan. Allah, alhamdulillah, protects for us the hadith and the Quran. So when we say the source of aqidah is the Quran and sunnah, we mean the authentic sunnah only. The authentic sunnah only. We have to accept the sunnah. We have to accept the sunnah. طيب. He mentioned, إن كان أحاداً في العقائد وغيرها. He mentioned the term أحد. Maybe I explained this term before. Again, I will explain. Why? Because this is very important. The hadith, if you study the hadith, you'll find the scholars mention the hadith. When you study the chain of the hadith, there are two types. There is a mutawatir hadith and there is an ahad hadith. Okay. These two types, not from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and not from the companions radiallahu ta'ala. This is late, after maybe the companions in 100 or 200 years. But at the time of the companions, khalas, if they know this is hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, khalas, I will accept it. If the chain is authentic. Of course, at the time, the companions, they will not check this is authentic or not authentic. Khalas, all the companions are trust. We trust all the companions. But later they said, there is hadith mutawatir and ahad. Okay, what is the difference? Yeah, and for example, now how many brothers here? Let's say 10 brothers. So suppose I'm the first one here. Then one brother came, then he said, one brother came from Hawali and he said, it is raining outside. The second brother from Salmiya, he said, it is raining. The third one from Mangaf, from Ahmadi, from Al-Jahra, from Selwa, from Al-Grain. So 10 people from different areas, 10 people from different areas. And all of them said the same information. So I'm now inside and I don't see and I don't hear. So because of 10 people, I should believe this information. And no doubt it is authentic. And this information called mutawatir. What's mean mutawatir? It came from different sources. And some scholars said if it is from 10 or more, it is called mutawatir. If it is 10 or more, it is called mutawatir. طيب. And if it is less than 10, they call it ahad. Okay? Mutawatir means from different sources, mutawatir. Several sources. Ahad, from the word one. It is called ahad, but even if it is 3 or 4, it is called ahad, or 9. Why should I explain this? Because These people, I mean the deviant people, they say, if the hadith is mutawatir, we accept this hadith if it is related to aqidah. But if the hadith is ahad, we should reject this hadith in aqidah. We don't accept this hadith in aqidah. Okay, what is the proof for this? They don't have proof. Okay, do we have any verse in the Quran or any hadith, Allah or the Prophet saying to us, you should consider the mutawatir in aqidah, not the ahad? They did not mention. And if you notice, the Prophet used to send one or two companions to give da'wah. And of course, the da'wah starts with what? Aqidah or fiqh? It starts with aqidah. The Prophet ﷺ told, Hadith Bukhari, he told Mu'ad, go to Yemen, they were Christians, إِنَّكَ تَقْدُمْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ, the people of the book. So you should start with what? With Tawheed. فَلَيْكُنْ أَوَّلَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ إِلَىٰ أَنْ يُوَحِدُوا اللَّهِ. You have to start with Tawheed. Okay, so now Mu'ad won. And the Prophet ﷺ sent him to Yemen. Okay, so it means the aqidah is acceptable even if it is from one source. But it should be authentic source. And no doubt Mu'ad is authentic. Okay, so as Muslims, as the way of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we have to accept the hadith if it is authentic. I don't care if it is mutawatir or ahad, I don't care. My concern is it authentic or not? The chain, is it authentic or not? It is authentic, khalas. طيب. So this is what he said about the source of aqidah. طيب. Then he mentioned, what is the reference in understanding the Quran and Sunnah? He said, the understanding of the Salaf al-Salih. Okay, when we mention Salaf al-Salih, we mean the first three generations, mainly the companions, the generation of the companions, then the second generation after the companions, then the third generation. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said, خير الناس قرني. The best generation is my generation. Then, ثم الذين يلونهم. Then the next generation. ثم الذين يلونهم, then the third generation. Okay, so now the source of aqidah is the Quran and the authentic Sunnah. But the next point, how should I understand the Quran and Sunnah? By the understanding, under the understanding of the Salaf. It means the companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum. How did they understand the Quran and Sunnah? This should be my way. Because some people say, why should I follow the understanding of the companions? They are human beings. They do mistakes. And also we are human beings. So khalas, there is no difference between us and them. No, this is wrong. There is a big difference between us and them. Of course, we don't mean they don't do any sin. They don't do mistakes. No doubt, they are human beings and they have mistakes. But as a general, as a companion, all of them, they don't do mistakes. I mean their consensus. And also their understanding is different than our understanding. Simply, if you attend a lecture, okay, for example, now you are with me, do you think that your understanding will be the same if you listen to the lecture after 1 week, only a voice, okay? And I'm using my hand, and like at the beginning, I was making the nod, okay? No doubt, the understanding will be different, will be less, generally speaking, okay? So the companions saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in front of them. So why should we follow the understanding of the companions radiallahu ta'ala? And number one, because they are the best generation. Allah praised them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praised them. He said, the best generation is my generation. Khayrun nas. The best people is my generation. And also because they lived with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They lived with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and no doubt their understanding will be much better than our understanding. And also the Arabic language. And there are different things. There are several points make the understanding of the companions stronger than our understanding. So we have to stick to the understanding of the companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. And it is enough to know the ayah. Allah says in the Quran, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمِنْ شَاقِقَ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ بَصِيرًا. Allah says in the Quran, وَمِنْ شَاقِقَ الرَّسُولِ, it means to be in one side and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in another side. Then he is following غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, he is following different than the way of the believers. Okay, who are the believers at the time of Quran? The Sahaba, the companions. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرِ سَبِيلِ النَّبِي, and he's following something different than the way of Rasulullah. So he said different than the way of the companions. So we have to follow the way of the companions, radiallahu ta'ala. And if you deviate from their way, you'll be in the hellfire. نُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ, he will be burned in جَهَنَّمْ وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. طيب, so this is the reference, the understanding of السلف الصالح on top, the companions رضي الله تعالى عنهم. Also he said أصول الدين, the principles and the foundations of the religion was clear by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And it is not allowed for anyone to create anything new in the religion. I mean the principles of deen. The basics, the principles of aqeedah, all of them were clear by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And we are not allowed to create anything new. Why? It will be bid'ah and it will be dalala, it will be misguidance. Also, it is important to know in aqeedah the submission, at-tasleem, wal-inqiyad, the submission. You as Muslim, what is the meaning of Islam? What does it mean that you are Muslim? I mean the term Muslim. Muslim from istislam, from submission. You have to submit. You have to submit. طيب, you have to accept everything in Islam. So you have to submit for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Zahiran wa batinan. Zahiran, what you say and what you act, wa batinan, and also what you believe. Okay, both your actions, your sayings, and also your beliefs should be, yes, you have to submit for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you should not oppose the Quran and Sunnah by your logic. Wallahi, yes, Islam is good, but I don't agree with that, the woman should cover the body by hijab. This is a freedom. Habibi, if Allah says, khalas, you have to follow. طيب. So it means you are not Muslim. If you try to oppose and to contradict the Islam with your understanding and your logic, then you are not submitting. No, you have to submit. You have to say, سمعنا وطعنا. You have to say, سمعنا وطعنا. Do you know the last ayat in Surah Al-Baqarah? The last three ayat. Hadith in Sahih Muslim, Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah revealed, لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِنْ تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبُكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. At the beginning, طيب, Allah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِنْ تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ, whatever you do or you say, okay, apparently, or whatever you hide, it will be accountable. Imagine if in your heart, something, if you intend in your heart, and you are sitting, you are not doing, and you are not saying anything, okay, it will be accountable. When Allah revealed this ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah, some of the companions went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they said, "O Rasulullah, we were asked to fight jihad, to pray, to give charity, to do this, this. We did. But there is something we cannot do." The Prophet asked them, "Well, what do you mean?" Then they mentioned this ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will account what is inside our heart, and we cannot. The Prophet said, "أتريدين أن تقولوا كما قال أهل الكتابين?" Do you like to say, like the people who were before you, the people of the book? They said, "سمعنا وعصينا." We listen and we disobey. You have to say, "سمعنا وأطعنا." You have to say, "We listen and we obey." Okay, so the companions did not answer the Prophet ﷺ anything, and they say, "Yes, khalas." They agreed with the Prophet ﷺ, khalas, because this is from Allah and this is from Rasulullah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala canceled that rule by the next ayah. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليهم ربهم المؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah will not ask any soul except what it can do. لها ما كسبت وعليه ما اكتسبت. So Allah made it easier for them, so it is not accountable if you intend to do something. طيب يعني in the hadith, Allah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned the hadith that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not account if you until you do or you say. If there is something in your heart but you do not say and you do not do, طيب خلاص, it will not, there not, there will not be sin. But if you do or you say, خلاص, it will be accountable. طيب, so يعني this was alhamdulillah much easier. Imagine if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will account what is inside our heart. Inside my heart is to do the haram or to miss the fajr or to a lot of mistakes. But alhamdulillah, Allah will not account what inside our hearts. And also he said, we should submit for the Quran and Sunnah, and we should not oppose the Quran and Sunnah by an opinion of a scholar. Also, this is a part of Aqeedah. طيب, يعني, for example, I tell you, the Prophet said, don't do this. Then you tell me, but the Shaykh said it is okay. A'udhu billah. I'm telling you, the Prophet ﷺ said, don't do this. And you say, you mention, you quote something from a Shaykh, from a scholar, then you have a problem in your Aqeedah. You have a problem in your Aqeedah. Okay, you can't discuss the issue. Is it wajib, mustahab, makruh, haram? You can't discuss. But don't oppose something. The companion Abdullah ibn Umar said, radiyallahu ta'ala, he was with his son. Okay, in one narration that his son is, his name is Bilal, not Bilal ibn Rabah. No, another Bilal, not a companion. Bilal ibn Abdullah. So Abdullah ibn Umar said, he mentioned a hadith. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تمنعوا إماءكم المساجد. Abdullah ibn Umar said this hadith in front of his son, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't stop your wife, or don't stop the woman, it means your wife, your daughter, if she wants to pray in the masjid. Then his son Bilal said, wallahi la namna'uhun, by Allah, I will stop them. Then Abdullah ibn Umar got got very angry. And he said, I am telling you the Prophet ﷺ, that the Prophet ﷺ said, don't stop them. And you say, I will stop them. By Allah, I will not speak to you forever. And he insulted his son. Why? Because he opposed the hadith of Rasulullah ﷺ by his opinion. Subhanallah. No, this is not allowed. It's not allowed. This is part of aqidah. You have to accept. Okay, you can discuss. The Prophet ﷺ said, don't do this. Is it makruh or haram? But if they discuss. But don't say yes if the Prophet ﷺ said no. Or if the Prophet ﷺ said yes, you say no. Don't make it in this way. Don't make it in this way. You have to accept. I respect the hadith of Rasulullah ﷺ on my head. Okay? But maybe there is another hadith, or you like to clarify the point, or you want to check is it authentic or not. This is okay. Maybe I caught a hadith for you. You this is your right to ask, is it authentic or not? No problem. Ask and check the hadith. Or you like to ask, what is the meaning of the hadith? But don't say yes, and the hadith says no, or the opposite. You have to be careful. Also, he mentioned a very important point, that al-aql al-sarih, طيب, موافق للنقل الصحيح. This is also very important. العقل الصحيح والنقل العقل الصريح والنقل الصحيح. We have two things. We have the authentic source. It means the Quran and the authentic hadith, and the logic. Okay, the scholars of Ahlus Sunnah al-Jama'ah, they say, never the logic contradicts the Quran and Sunnah. Maybe many times they say, but this hadith doesn't go with the science. This the for sure, the Quran and the authentic Sunnah don't contradict the logic. And if you see there's contradiction, maybe the problem with your logic, the problem with your understanding, or maybe the problem with the hadith is not authentic. Maybe the hadith is not authentic. And Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah wrote a book, a big huge book about this. Not only him, also Ibn Qutayba. There are different books about the ahadith and the ayat you think they are contradicting. And one of the scholars said, I am ready for anyone. Bring for me any hadith you think that they are contradicting, and I will solve them for you. I will tell you how to join them. So for sure, okay, if the hadith is authentic, will not contradict a logic. And there are many, 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 many things. For example, the famous example, they mentioned this example in the books. طيب, I will end with this hadith, with this example. They say, there is hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا عدوى ولا طيرة ولا هامة ولا صفر. طيب. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا عدوى. Okay. What is meaning for adwa? There's nothing infectious. A disease goes from one person to another person. Okay? There is nothing like this. طيب. And at the same hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا عدوى. Then a man asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, O Rasulullah, we can't see the camels. The same hadith. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the same hadith. وفر من المجدوم فرارك من الأسد and escape from المجدوم. مجدوم is an infectious disease. فر من المجدوم فرارك من الأسد. Escape from this sick person as you are escaping from the lion. طيب, so maybe some people they say يعني they are contradicting.